So friends, we are going to connect very first circuit. This is class A commutation, and we have given one internal DC source. It is of 24 volt DC, and one fuse also we have connected in series to protect the short circuit current. If in a case by mistake some thing will be shorted, so it will be protected by this fuse. Okay, and this is my plus minus terminal of the SMPS, okay, which is provided internally. So I am connecting this black to black minus, and this is red, this is plus. Okay, so we have connected one DC source of 24 volt here, and now we have to construct this construct this classic commutation circuit by connecting these all components which are given separately. So now I am connecting one thyristor. So this is my thyristor TM, this is main thyristor. So I am connecting here, and it is going to here anode to anode, then cathode, this is cathode to cathode. Okay, so here I have connected one cathode, and this is my cathode terminal. Okay, now next one is inductor. So this is my inductor. Now I have to connect inductor over here. So I am connecting one inductor like this. Okay. Now the second point will be connected over here, and next component will be resistor. So I am connecting all these three devices will be connected in series. It is very simple circuit because it is class A commutation, and normally we call load commutation. So we know the principle of operation as to make it off, we have to reduce the HCR current below its holding current by creating some resonance at the load side. Okay, so we are intentionally we are creating resonance to make it off. Okay, now I am connecting my DSO across the thyristor to observe my thyristor voltage. Okay, and I am expecting it will be similar to the reference waveforms. As we know, we have taken reference from Khan Chandani and P.S. Bhimrao sir books. So definitely we will try to achieve the same result over here. Hopefully I have connected the all components, necessary components, to the class A commutation circuit. Now I am making on. So on DSO screen you can see we are right now observing the VTH, and if you compare this waveform with your reference book, so exactly it will be same, and it is ideal waveform. So quite similar, we can say quite similar we are getting over here. This is VTH waveform, and we have supplied, or we have given only 20% of gate pulse on gate pulse to the thyristor, and remaining it is off. So this kind of shape we are getting across the thyristor, and if you observe you wanted to observe the load current as well, so you have to connect this shunt resistor into this series. Okay, so this shunt resistor will be connected into this series of this RL, and here from here these green terminals you can observe the wave shape of the load current. Okay, not exactly the current, because we know we are observing the waveform across the this current. So in terms of millivolt we will be getting, and it is similar to the load current shape. So ultimately we will be sensing only load current shape, okay, not the magnitude, because we have used one shunt resistor and it is about 0.1 ohm, so it is quite low to reduce our power losses in the sensing mechanism. Now hopefully you will be getting all the waveforms, and this is the indication of load energize, as we have connected one LED across this resistor. So it is glowing, means your load is energized or your commutation circuit is on. Now I am going to operate the second commutation circuit. It is called class B. So make sure to make connection your circuit should be in off state. Okay, I made it off. Now I am switching over the same terminal to this class B commutation circuit. This is minus of supply, this is plus of supply, then this is my switch. So this is my switch anode, this is my cathode. Okay, this is my cathode. Now here we have to connect resistor in the series of this circuit. So this is my resistor points. We have two points of resistor. I am connecting one from here to here, and second point of resistor should be connected to the minus of the supply. Okay, now inductor is remaining, and this is my inductor. It is connected parallelly, we can say. This is parallel combination of LC because it is class B commutation, and class B commutation is resonating commutation, or we can say inductor and capacitor should be connected across the switch to make it off. Okay, so now we will see how we are getting the commutation of this thyristor by energizing these two passive components, we know L and C, and we have some standard equation also. So in I can also share with this in manual also the design parameters of all kinds of commutation circuits. So I'm making on here, you can see the exactly same graph or the VTH signal VTH waveform we are getting as per the reference. Okay, and it is taken from, also I'm repeating, Khan Chandani sir book. So this kind of thyristor voltage should be achieved, and we have achieved the same signal or same waveform. So you can measure many signals, possible signals, intermediate signals, but in video I am just covering how to operate and how to connect the external components with your class ABCDEF class circuits. So this is the way of connecting. Before connection, your circuit should be in off state, and then you can connect the external components. Okay, so hopefully it will be helpful to you while you'll be experimenting the same kit in your laboratory. And now I'm switching over to the third class C commutation circuit. Okay, so same connection we have to do here. Repeating, I am just plus to plus, minus to minus. So this is minus, this is plus, and this is my thyristor. So this is my thyristor. Here we are going to use two thyristors, okay, because as per the